बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। एज टुडे एज वी आर मूविंग इन द फर्स्ट एरा ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, द फील्ड ऑफ नॉलेज साइंस एजुकेशन इज आल्सो डाइवर्सिफाइंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अकम्पलिश अ स्मॉल पोर्शन ऑफ फील्ड ऑफ केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग, दैट इज कूलिंग टावर। कूलिंग टावर is a heat removal devices used to transfer process waste to the atmosphere. Cooling tower is used for the evaporation of water to remove heat and cool the working fluid near the wet bulb air temperature. Okay, background: the machines and process of industry as well as devoted to human comfort and well-being generate tremendous amount of heat which must be continuously dissipated if those machines and processes are to be continue efficiently. Although this heat is usually transferred to cool flowing of water, final rejection is always to the atmosphere. The natural process of evaporation makes them very effective heat transfer mediums. Although the happy man depicted in figure 1 may not completely understand the principle of evaporation, he is initiatively making use of most ancient form of natural cooling. Okay. Now we move to the types of cooling towers. One is atmospheric tower and the second is mechanical draft tower. And the third is hybrid draft. Now, first is atmospheric tower. Atmospheric tower use no mechanical device, derive airflow by natural induction, relatively inexpensive, applied in very small sizes, far more affected by adverse conditions. Atmospheric towers use no mechanical device to create airflow through the tower. This tower drives its airflow from natural induction provided by air spray type water distribution system. Although relatively inexpensive, they are usually applied only in very small sizes and are far more affected by adverse wind conditions than are other types. Their use on process requiring accurate, dependable cold water temperatures is not recommended and therefore rarely used. Okay. Now we move to the next, mechanical draft tower. There are two types of this tower. Number one is induced cooling tower and the second is forced draft cooling tower. The airflow in either class may be cross flow or counter flow with respect to the falling water. Cross flow indicates that the airflow is horizontal in the filled portion of the tower, while counter flow means the airflow is in the opposite direction of the falling tower. Thanks.
Now, forced draft cooling tower. Fan at base, no lowered exterior walls, covered with panel. The forced draft tower shown in the picture has the fan, basin and piping located within the tower structure. In this model, the fan is located at the base. There are no lowered exterior walls. Instead, the structure, steel or wood framing is covered with paneling made of aluminum, galvanized steel or asbestos cement bombs. Induced draft. Air upwards, water flow downward, heat transfer efficiency. The induced draft tower shown in the following picture has one or more fans located at the top of the tower that draw air upward against the downward flow of water passing around the wooden decking or packing. Since the airflow is counter to the water flow, the coolest water at the bottom is in contact with the driest air while the warmest water at the top is in contact with the moist air, resulting in increased heat transfer efficiency. Now, hybrid draft. mechanical draft, fan assisted natural draft cover, high ambient and peak load. They are equipped with mechanical draft fans to augment airflow. Consequently, they are also referred to as fan assisted natural draft cover. The intent of their designing is to minimize the horsepower required for the air movement, but to do so with the least possible stack cost impact. Properly designed, the fans may need to be operated only during periods at high ambient stand peak loads.
Characterization of cooling tower by airflow. There are 5 types of cooling tower with respect to airflow. First one is counter flow, second is cross flow, third is double flow, fourth is single flow, and fifth is spray field. The first cooling tower is counter flow, in which vertically upward suppressed air is used, extended intake and the discharge plenum. Actually, in this suppress system, the air is moved vertically upward with a exhaust fan at the top of the cooling tower, and the water supply system is used and utilize more fan power than their cross flow in this supply system. Second one is cross flow. In cross flow, fill configuration and downward fall and effect of gravity. In cross flow, the fill configuration and the water is downward fall from the top to bottom, and air is also from the top to bottom is moved. The cooled water is came out from the bottom of the airflow, and also exhaust fan is used at the top of the cooling tower. And next is double flow. In double flow, they are inducting air fans to inlets. In this kind of tower, the fan is inducting air through two inlets and across the two banks of fill. Third is single flow. One air inlet and one fill bank. Three sides of the tower being cased. Used in unrestricted air path. This cooling tower is used in the cold store used in cold store for vegetable and fruit in vegetable and fruit. This kind of tower only has one air inlet and one fill bank. The remaining three sides of the tower being cased single flow tower are used in location where air unrestricted air path to be tower is available from only one direction. Fifth one is spray field. In this cooling tower, no heat transfer surface. Depending upon water breakups, promote maximum water to air. No particular inlets. In this suppress system, there is nothing any particular inlet, but the water is break up with a fan, and upper side a motor is used which is used to move the fan. The blade break ups the water and produce the cooling effect. This type of cooling tower is used at the CNG station and other type to cool the gas like gas stations and other gases in the industry.
Now I'm going to explain the characterization by construction of a cooling tower. Basically, there are two different types of a cooling tower by construction. The first one is field-directed cooling tower, and the second one is factory-assembled cooling tower. Namely, the first one is the field-directed cooling tower, in which function at the site of ultimate use prefabricated piece market. Direction of flow. The field erected cooling towers are those on which the primary construction activity takes place at the site of ultimate use. All large towers and many of the smaller towers are prefabricated piece markets and shipped to the site for the cooling towers. Manufacturer usually provide final assembly. Basically, in field-directed cooling tower, all the specific functions are performed at the specific site independent of other functions. The next one is the factory-assembled cooling tower. It is completely assembled, function at the point of manufacture, efficient in working. the factory assembled cooling tower undergo virtually complete assembly at their point of manufacture, whereupon they are shipped to the site in as few sections as mode of transportation will permit. The further is types of a cooling tower by shape. The first one is rectilinear, next is round mechanical draft, and the third one round mechanical draft. Rectilinear cooling tower. It is evident from the name that it is cellular in fashion, increasing linearly cells' special thermal performance. These towers are constructed in cellular fashion, increasing linearly to the length and numbers of cells necessary to accomplish a special thermal performance. From the figure, we can see that the upper portion is drift animator, the between is water distribution, and the third one is fill. Basically, the function of fill is to promote, it is a specific component that promotes both the maximum contact surface and the maximum contact time between air and water, and it determines the efficiency of the tower. The next is round mechanical draft. Round in plane configuration, fans clustered, multifaceted, octagonal mechanical draft. Round mechanical draft is basically a tower round in plane configuration, or essentially round with fans clustered as close but practicable around the center point of the tower. Multifaceted towers such as the octagonal mechanical drafts also fall into similar classification. Tower. In round mechanical draft, the basically configuration is different from that is a rectilinear draft. In this, the upper portion is water distribution, the next is the fill, and the third one is drift animator. Drift animator remove entertain water from the discharge air by causing it to make sudden change in direction.
Method of heat transfer. Plum abatement, water conservation towers, overall heat transfer. All these cooling towers that we have described in our presentation are evaporative type towers. In that, they derive their primary cooling effect from the evaporation that takes place when air and water are brought into direct contact. At the other end, the spectrum is the dry tower, where by full utilization of dry surface coil sections, no direct contact occurs between air and water. Hence, sensible heat transfer cools the water totally. In between these extremes are the plume abatement and water conservation towers, wherein progressively greater portions of dry surface coil sections are introduced into the overall heat transfer system to alleviate the specific problems or to accomplish specific requirements. Now, at the end, industries in which cooling tower is used. Petroleum refineries, fabric industries, power plants, coal-fired power plants, nuclear power plants, and water treatment plants. In all these refinery industry and plants, cooling tower has its own purpose in its working. Now, we are after defining all the types, functioning and working of cooling towers. This is the animated working of a cooling tower. How a cooling tower works. Power stations make lots of waste hot water. It is cooled into the tower, so we can again use it. So what we can see here is a cooling tower, and after that, the pipes are showed in which when the hot water is coming in, then cold water is going out of the surface, out of the cooling tower. Now, here is the bottom of a cooling tower. Cold air gets in and at the base of the cooling tower. Now, let's come into the internal structure of cooling tower. Hot water trickles down and is cooled by the air. Cold water is collected and sent back to the industry and for any purpose we are going to use it.
And after that, this is the whole structure. We can see that hot air in the tower rises and makes a cloud of water vapor. So this is the working of a cooling tower, which just is described in few seconds. This is end of our presentation. Thank you so much. Regards, Farooq Sarfaraz, Adil Munir, Rizwan Hussain, Bilawal Kuraya, and Sima Masood. Thank you all.